Today we're going to look at card windows in FileMaker. These are a new interface tool to FileMaker 16 and offer a lot of powerful options to developers. I'm going to go to my Invoices page here, click on an invoice, and go to this Payments tab, and if I click Add Payments, it'll open a card window. This is the same as opening a regular FileMaker window, except that the layout is embedded over the existing layout with this overlay, and you have the option to dim the parent window. So this is a new window, and FileMaker treats it like a new window, but it's anchored to the original layout, so you can kind of move it. When you move the original window, it'll move that card with it. Additionally, this is a modal window, so the user can't do anything. They can't close this or minimize until they address your card window. So you always want to have a button on here to save, which closes the window, or cancel, or a dialog button, which dismisses the window. So some great use cases for card windows are when you need a dialog for the user to input data, which requires something a little bit more robust than a custom dialog, than just a basic custom dialog. You can have many fields on here. You can also have custom buttons of whatever size with icons, so you can style this however you want. And you really have the whole layout toolkit available to you for modifying and setting up your custom dialogs. So in this case, my use case here is I'm adding a payment to an invoice. So this allows me to capture many different fields and create a related payment record. So we're just going to go ahead and add a credit, $300. And if I click save, then I can capture that data and create a related record here, a related payment record. Another great use case for a card window would be a picker or a selector. This is when you want to relate two records together. For example, like adding a product to an invoice as a line item. So if I click that add line item, it'll pull up my product selector. This is pulling everything from the product table. And I can filter down, click on a product, and it'll add that to this as a line item. And I can go ahead there and put a quantity in. And it's reflected in the total. So how do you set up a card window? It's very simple. You just go to the scripts workspace. And then in your script, you can go ahead and use the new window script step, and you just select the option card from the options here. You've got document, floating document, dialog, and card. And that card window will have some window options down here, which you can expand or collapse. And they have the option to have a close button. That's just a default close window button. Very useful when you're developing, so you don't lock yourself in that modal card window. And then you have the option to dim the parent. If you uncheck this, the card window will pop up, but the parent window will stay. It'll stay lit up. Couple notes here. The card window will be the size of the selected layout that it starts on until you use another script step to resize it. So, and if you have the card window as the current window in FileMaker, the regular window adjustment script steps, adjust window, move resize window, and close window will all execute on that card window just as you would expect with a regular window. Note there, you actually can move the window, the card outside of the parent window, so it won't get cut off if you want to move it outside of the parent window. That is a possibility available to you. If you want to use the example file that I'm using today, this is FM Quick Start. It is available at fmquickstart.com, which will be linked below, and you can download this fully unlocked and start using it today.